Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, and welcome if you're new. I'm glad to have you here. I had a lovely quiet Saturday morning where the kids were entertaining themselves and my husband was out running, so I thought I'd sneak into my art room and do a quick page for you here. Sorry about this being out of focus, but it does. I don't know, I was having an issue with my camera, but it comes back in a minute. I'm working in my little leather bound journal this morning, and I'm just using up a load of masking tape that I had. I've been doing some watercolour painting and I had this masking tape left over, and I don't like throwing it away, so I just stuck that down. And then I grabbed some washi tape to add into that. I don't often use washi tape, but what I tend to do with washi tape is I buy loads of it and then hoard it because it's too lovely to use. But I did grab some to use today, and I just wanted to add in some different colours and patterns in there. Then I'm going to go over that with gesso just to get it ready for some mediums to go over the top. But all that lovely texture still shows through. I love using masking tape to add texture. I'm starting off with some walnut ink. This is great stuff to use, but it doesn't half smell. I'm not keen on the smell of it at all. But yeah, it's nice to use for its colour. And next to my desk, these are gelato, and I never use them, but I thought they were just there, so today I just grabbed them and went with it. And I'm just using my finger to rub into the brown of the ink there to blend it all together. I'm grabbing this is a Prima Marketing Tropicals set of watercolours. It's got this lovely deep pink, so I'm adding a little bit of that in there. Now, a little bit more gesso just to brighten up the white space. I do like my white space. I do like leaving a bit of that in there. Just some nice light tones. There we go, I've taken that little background paper out that backing paper so you can see a bit better. I'm just making really intuitive little marks here just with a pencil. I'm not really thinking about it. I'm just sort of letting it come quite naturally, keeping it quite loose. I like how that turned out. I'm liking the marks. I wasn't that keen on the background, but then adding these marks on stuff, yeah, made it loads better. I'm using this tiny little letter stamp, just to add a little bit more detail into that. That's new, I bought that the other day. And I found this photograph in my stash, and it's this man who looks up to no good, to be honest. He looks quite shady, and there's this kind of shadow in the left-hand corner which looks very ominous. It just had a story to it, really, and I decided to go with that one. So I've sewn some bits of material to it, and I'm going to glue that down there on the right-hand side of the page. And I kind of like the sepia sort of picture, kind of went quite nicely with the background that I'd done. And then I found some words from an old book, my favourite way of adding some words. That's a tiny little it says it, but it would not, it just kept sticking to my fingers and wouldn't get down onto the page. So I had to fight with it a little bit, but we got there in the end. I'm really liking this little journal. It's one I've made myself, just with some little leather scraps and lots of different papers that I added in. I added in some of dictionary papers and coffee dye and all sorts. It says, he has taken it all, not once, but many times. I thought that kind of suited that picture. I'm just, I just sprayed some water in it. This is just coffee, and I'm just, it had dried out, so I'm just adding some more moisture into it to reconstitute it. Is that the right word? And I just wanted a few splashes. And that's it. It's only a little page today. I hope you've enjoyed it. See you later. Bye.